Hey guys, this week let's talk about organization. So by default, I'm not someone who is organized. You can ask my friends, my family, my ex-coworkers, they know how disorganized I am. But since I took YouTube full-time and then it took off and then I started hiring people, I just can't afford to be disorganized. So this is where Notion comes into place. So I've been using Notion since February 2020, so it's about 1.5 years now. So I was extremely happy when Notion reached out to me like a month ago to do a sponsored video. I was like, yes, I would do it. So without further ado, let's get into it. So for those of you guys who are not aware what Notion is, it's basically an all-in-one productivity app. It's an app that you use to quite literally organize your life. They do call themselves on the website an all-in-one workspace, and I gotta tell you, they really live up to it. So why do I love Notion? There are actually two main reasons why I love it. First, it's because it's all-in-one, as they promote themselves to be. It literally organizes my essentials that I really need day-to-day in just one workspace. So before I found out about Notion, I used to do things in different apps. So to make a to-do list, I use app A. To track progress, I used to use this app called Trello. For content calendar, I use my Google Drive, whatever, you know. But now, with Notion, all of my essentials are in one place. Second, it's versatile. You can personalize it and customize it just how you like it. It has so much room for creativity. I will walk you through a little bit later in this video, but you'll see here. For instance, you can do a checklist view, which is great to make to-do lists, you know, where you can check it off if you have done something and it gives you a sense of accomplishment. You can do a board view, which is great to track progress. And you can do a calendar view, which is great to give you a visualization of your deadlines. And even a list view, just like how you have it on Excel. And yes, like I said before, it's really just a blank canvas and you can personalize it as much as you want, how you want it to be. You can also make it pretty by adding an icon, and also you can change the cover as how you like it. You can use their existing gallery, you can upload your own, or you can even use a stock photo that is integrated in the app. Let's just use this. There you go. Next, let's try to make it fun for you. So let's create a page together, just a simple one. You can just click add a page here. And you can name it whatever you want. So let's just call it my page. You can change the icon if you want. You can add a cover. My internet is a little slow. And this is where the magic happens. If you click the / button on your keyboard, you can choose which of these blocks that you want to use for this page. Here you can create a text box. This is perfect for you to just start writing, either script writing or notes or whatever. And then if you click a page, this is basically creating a page under this my page. What the heck does that mean? So let's see. You just create a new page, and then you will see that this new untitled page falls under the my page that you just created. And if you toggle it right here, you can see that there's another untitled page that you just created, but we don't want that. And the rest is quite self-explanatory. If you want to create a to-do list, you do this, bullet list, toggle, yada, yada, yada. And here, under the database, this is actually when it starts to get really cool. So here you can see there's table, board, gallery, calendar, inline, but you can also see a full page version of it. But what's the difference between that? So if you create a full page page, it's basically creating a new full sub page under this my page as we just created. So let's say we want to create a table full page. There you go. There's a new untitled page under the one that we just created, but we don't want that, so let's delete it. Whereas with inline, you're just going to create a block under this page that we just created. There you go. So with an inline page, you can also make it more dynamic. So let's say if we have a table up here and we want to use another block down there, so we can as you can see, you can make it as simple and as complex as you want. So yeah. So yeah, if you download Notion, you can go crazy and try to create your own blocks like this. It's quite fun. I think once you get into it, you just want to keep trying to experiment what you can create from it. So you see how fun that was? So if you're interested to download Notion for yourself, you can use the link here or in the description box. If you download from that link, Notion will know that my video gets people to download it and they will like my performance and they're gonna wanna work with me again in the future, and that would make me happy. But if you decide to download the app just by yourself, go ahead. But yeah, Right, so now I'm gonna show you a walkthrough of my Notion setup. So one of the most important things that I use Notion for is just my to-do list. So it's pretty straightforward. My to-do list just looks like this. It's kind of like a checklist template where I could just kind of like check off all of the things that I have done today. I actually have made it a vaccination appointment today, so I should check it off. And I like the fact that when I check it off, it gives me a sense of accomplishment. So before this, I used to have a to-do list page that is a bit more complex, that has a lot more things that I have to do, like I'm gonna show you. So this is my old to-do list page. So as you can see, there's a today's to-do list, there's a to-do soon, there's ongoing projects, there's this week's list, blah, blah. The thing is, when I put too many things in my to-do list, I get a bit overwhelmed by how many things that I still have to do. So I decided to make a new page like this and make it simple. Just the things that I have to do today and this week. So when the week goes by, sometimes I think about, oh wait, I actually have to buy a plastic for the trash. So then I just put it on a this week's list. And then I have a 2021 goals list. So basically it's kind of like the same like my to-do list, however this is more yearly, you know, so it's kind of like a bigger, more long-term version of my daily to-do list. So before I used Notion, I used to do my Google Notes app to list my goals that I wanted to achieve by this year. However, the problem with that is that when I make a list on my notes, usually that list would get buried by, you know, all of these new notes that I would come up with. So after a while, once it gets buried, I forgot about it and I just don't focus my mind and my work into reaching those goals. Whereas now on Notion, it's right there on the left sidebar and I could access it whenever I want, because I don't just open Notion to look at my goals. I use it as a project manager tool, as my to-do list app, as a progress tracking app. So it's always there. I'm always reminded about the goals that I want to achieve this year, and that keeps me focused. Okay, now we move on to the projects page. So I use this page to make an overview of all of the projects that I'm currently working on. So before I made this page, my head was always so cluttered about all of these different projects that are flying around in my head and always having to remind myself which stage I am in each project. And I always question myself on why I decided to take so many projects at once. So now in this list, you can see the list of all of the projects that I'm currently involved in and also the people that are responsible for that, so my whole team. And the priority of it, is it really important, is it medium, or is it really low? So, and also the direct value. So this direct value is really important, because if, let's say, if I decided to take up a new project that isn't exactly bringing me closer to reaching my goals, I would probably rethink the importance of it. Like, is it really worth pursuing this project or not? So all of the projects that I'm working on right now would either bring me direct value in financially, so will it give me direct income, or would it improve my brand awareness? So for instance, right now TikTok is at a low priority. I don't really work on it as much. Actually, my team is a bit more responsible for that, because it's not really bringing me direct value. TikTok only serves for me as an experiment, so that's why I put it on low value, so I shouldn't really be too focused on that. So that's an overview of my project. So after project, so now we move on to my YouTube page. So as you can see here, under my YouTube page, there's a couple of sub pages. So I can see the sub pages in this view. I can also toggle it right here, which actually I prefer. So let's move on to the content calendar, which is something that I love about Notion, because then it allows me to schedule my content with a calendar view. So a calendar view is really important for me to visualize my deadline. So I love seeing all of my content schedule in one place like this. So it really gives me an idea of what I have to focus on every week, in terms of content, of course. In this main channel, I always upload every Friday, and my other Indonesian channel, Nailingua, I upload every Tuesday. And all of these reels in yellow, those are Instagram reels, because I have to. So since Instagram rolled out its reels feature, it's been performing a lot. So I think they're really trying to encourage people to use more reels, because they're in competition with TikTok. So I really want to prioritize reels on Instagram, so I really have to put it on my calendar. And one thing that Notion does that I love a lot is that it allows sharing with my team. So even though, let's say, even if my team doesn't have a Notion app on their phone or on their web, they can still click a link and that would direct them to a Notion webpage. So they would have the same view of the calendar as I do, so what I see here they can see as well. So it will give them an idea on what they should focus on that week, just the same like me, you know? What's really cool about this is that I get to see not only the calendar view of all of my content, but I could also see more information of each of the content that I've scheduled here. Let's say last week on the 23rd, I uploaded a video about verbal fluency. If I click on here, there's more info that I could add here and that I could find about that video. And if I want to, I could actually write the script here, you know. I could just kind of like write the script here. It's probably a lot more convenient to write it here, but me personally, when I write like a long piece of writing, like a script or I don't know, like a document or a book, something like that, I prefer to write on Google Doc because being on Google Doc, just the tool itself, it puts me in writing mode. Whereas if I were to write on Notion, it does put me in an organization mode, you know? So that's just personal, but it's really cool to know that if I choose to start writing my script here on Notion because I want everything in one place, I have the option to. I could just write the script here if I want. But thankfully with Notion, I could also embed or include the link to my script of verbal fluency on Google Drive. I have my script saved on Google Drive and then I just created the link and I could just open it and it leads me to the document. So now we move on to my content ideas page. So this is a page where I would organize my idea dump, my ideas dump. So normally I dump my rough ideas on Google Notes because it's just a lot easier to start writing on Google Notes. And normally I get content ideas on like the most random times of the day. Let's say when I go for a walk or when I'm out with my friends or even in the bathroom, I come up with ideas, then I just start jotting it down on Google Notes. And once I sit down on the desk, my laptop open, that's when I transfer all of my rough ideas from Google Notes to Notion in a more organized manner like this, you know? So you can see here, these are where I put all of my ideas and then I also put them into categories. Is it self-development, language learning, living abroad, or whatever? So it's just kind of like different themes of my channel. So I also added this stage. So is it in writing stage or idea stage? So idea stage is when I've come up with the idea but I haven't really written anything about it, you know, whereas the writing stage is when I've come up with the idea and I've done something about it. I've done maybe two or three paragraphs about it. So that is in the writing stage. And on the scheduling column, this is whether or not I have put it on the content calendar page, because once it's on the content calendar page, that's when I know it's going to be a video in a few weeks time. Whereas this is just still on idea stage most of the time. So one thing that I like about Notion is that you can kind of link between pages. So for instance, let's see, right now I've already created a script for this video, how I learn Portuguese. So it's on the writing stage. I should have checked off the box, but what I can do is that, let's say I want to move it to the content calendar page where it's going to be a video. What I can do is that click those six button right there and then click this icon right here, move to content calendar. Where is that? Move to content calendar. And then when I go back to this page, content calendar, I can see there are some files here. Show pages without a date. Oops. So that was how I learned Portuguese and I just click it and then it just comes up in this date. And then from there, I can just easily drag it on to, I don't know, a date that I have not uploaded. Maybe I have not planned any videos for August, so I will add that here somewhere. I don't know. So it's really nice in Notion how I can link the pages with each other. So next we have the sponsors page. So this is a page where I use to track all of the brands that I'm working with. So since March, since I recruited a PR manager into my team, she's been getting me a lot of brand deals, which I'm so grateful for. And after a while, there's just a lot of brand deals coming in, and then it's starting to get a little bit harder for me to track all of the brands that we're working with. So in this page, I'm using the boards template, which is great to see a sense of progress, you know, like at which stage I am in with every brand that I'm working with. So here first you can see the no status column. So this is just a list of brands that I would like to work with within, I don't know, 3 months time or something. Back and forth is a stage where my manager has already been in contact with the contact person of that brand, wherein signed is a stage where I've already signed the deal and there's no turning back, you know, so I'm definitely going to do this deal. And then there's a content and date in progress stage where, you know, I'm already creating where the date is set and I'm working on the content already. And for instance, here I have Notion because at the moment the content is literally in progress right now. I'm shooting it right now. And then once the content has been reviewed, approved, and then uploaded on my channel, that's when I put it onto live. So what's nice about this is that after a while, I get to see how many brands I have worked with in the past. And let's say there is a brand that is asking me for a portfolio to show me a list of brands that I've worked with, I could just come up here and say, hey, these are the list of brands that I've worked with. And yeah, it's nice. It's just easy to access, you know. And then next, I have the public speaking and collab goals, which I'm not really gonna get into because I haven't really worked on this that much. And collab goals are just a list of brands. And lastly, I have this done page, which is a place for me to just dump everything that I don't need anymore, that is has already been done. For instance, actually, my scaling my business page, this was a plan that I made in 2020, where I was still a solopreneur, that was just me working without a team. And I really dreamed about having a team and scaling my business and getting my business to the next level. So I wrote out a plan on what my team would consist of, you know. So it would be a content creator, which I didn't really follow through. It would be a videographer, it would be a PR manager, it would be a social media manager and all that. But now, since this has been in the past, I think I'm going to move this to the done page. So it's pretty cool. Maybe in the end of the year, I would go into the done page and I will see what I have achieved, you know. So yeah, it's really cool to have it all. Well, that is it, guys. My Notion walkthrough. I hope you guys liked it. And I hope this walkthrough makes you want to download Notion for yourself. And thanks a lot. And I will see you next week in another video. Bye-bye.